If you had a crystal ball or an ideal of Mars 2050, what is that?
I don't know if in 2050 we'll have established enough of a foothold in Mars where we have cities or things like that, but I could see us having outposts where we have tens or maybe hundreds of people set up in an environment that's friendlier for humans and that allows them to go and explore Mars.
I think we'll be explorers at Mars by 2050. I think we'll have human explorers right there on the surface with robotic explorers. It's not just one point in space, right? It is a whole planet. And if you think about the amount of time and effort it's taken to explore our own planet, same amount of time to go explore Mars.
There's a real potential for the combination of humans and robots together in exploration and things that, you know, robots do very well that humans don't do as well and vice versa. And so partnering together in a sort of exploration way, I think could be really cool.
There are certain things that robots just can't do, and sending humans to Mars would really be a great boon for doing a lot of different kinds of science that here on Earth is really easy to do because we can go out there and look at it, and we don't have to program a robot to do everything for us where it's a bit limited, there's a time lag. People can think in real time. They see things that you might not see just from a camera that wouldn't notice it. So in my opinion, it would be really interesting and good for the science of Mars to actually send humans there.
In the future, right, there are certain things that we can imagine will probably improve scientifically, engineering-wise. Things like AI will certainly help us explore better. But then there's also certain things that you can't change, right?
Mars is a cold, dry, uninhabitable place, at least uninhabitable for humans.
Having humans survive on Mars is a big deal. So at the moment, we would have to take everything that we would need with us just to go visit Mars. We have been working on different kinds of experiments and things like that to think about how to use the resources at Mars to allow humans to exist there. There's actually an experiment on the Perseverance rover called an in-situ resource utilization experiment, where it's taking carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere and generating molecular oxygen. So we have started thinking about what it's going to take to actually have a human presence on Mars. And if we want to have not only people visit Mars, but stay, we're going to have to figure out how to use the resources that Mars has available.
So when we think about exploring, right, when we talk about NASA exploring elsewhere in the solar system, when we talk about exploring Mars, there's often this question about, you know, why do we go somewhere else? Why do we search out other places in the solar system? And I think that fundamentally, part of it comes back to this idea that Mars and Earth have a lot of similarities, right? And in a lot of ways, we can understand more about our planet by understanding things that are happening on other planets. It's just a profound experience to think that we're doing something ambitious, we're doing something audacious, we're going out, we're exploring, we're trying to understand more. And I think that there's a reason that all of this excites so many different people.